boys and girls, if you have finished your fish family like Annie did, she did an amazing job drawing and painting her fish. Today, you are going to making a fish sculpture. Now, a sculpture is different than a drawing because a sculpture is three-dimensional.
Sculpture?
What's sculpture? It's a sculpture, Rudy. A sculpture is not a shape, it's a form because it has a top, bottom, and sides. People have been making sculptures for thousands of years out of all kinds of different materials. We are going to be making a sculpture of a fish dish out of clay. So what is clay? Clay is actually just mud. It comes from the ground, and people have been using it for thousands of years to make sculptures. Now, sculptures can be decorative, which means they don't serve a purpose. They're just interesting to look at, like the sculpture of a, looks like a dog. Or they can be actually used for something, like our dish, our fish dish, can be used to actually put things in, like soap or anything you want, candy. The clay that we use comes deep from the ground. It's an earthenware clay. And the companies that sell the clay have to dig really, really deep down in the ground and find the clay. Because clay isn't just any kind of mud. It's actually a special kind of mud that's sticky. When it's wet, it sticks together and you can shape it into anything you want. So clay is kind of magic. We're going to be using that magic of clay to make a sculpture of a fish. So when I get my clay, whenever I'm working with clay, it can be pretty messy because clay is basically mud. So I always get newspaper so the clay doesn't stick to the table because clay can be very, very sticky. And the element of art that we're using is called form. So we're going to be making the form of a fish. I also keep a cup of water because when you join pieces of clay together to make a sculpture, you have to do something called score and slip. Score basically means that if you add any pieces onto your fish, like a fin, it has to be scratched, which is scored, and you have to use mud, which is slip. So to get started with your fish dish, you need a styrofoam bowl, and we need to make a template for your fish. So I have a white piece of paper, and this is just going to be the shape of your fish. It doesn't have to be the same fish that you drew in your fish family, but you do want to trace that circle of the bowl, because if you remember when we were drawing our fish, that we had to use shapes to draw them. Now that I've drawn my circle, I'm going to add a fin at the top, a tail at the end, another fin at the bottom, and then of course the cute lips. And I don't have to draw other details because this is just going to be the shape. Once I've drawn my template, then I need to get the scissors and I want to be really careful about cutting out my fish. You always want to be safe with scissors. Recycle in the recycling bin. So our clay I keep wrapped up in a bag. This is a big bag of clay. When it's wrapped up in plastic, it stays wet. So it should be soft. It is so soft, actually, that I can just cut it with a wire, just a wire string. So I'm going to cut off a piece of clay, and I just cut right through it, and there's my hunk of clay. Now, we don't want your dish to be too thick or too thin. Right now, this is too thick. So what I'm going to start doing is kind of squeezing the clay. And there's some different techniques that we can do. But this technique is called a slab technique. So other things you can do with clay are rolling into a ball, rolling into a coil, squeezing the clay, pulling the clay, scratching the clay, which is called scoring. There's all these things you can do with the clay. But like I said, we need a flat piece of clay, almost like a pancake. And this is too thick, so I'm squeezing it until it gets a little bit thinner. You can also throw it on the table and pound it. a rolling pin and I can flatten it out. Now, before I lay my template on and cut out my fish, it still isn't big enough, so I'm going to roll it out a little bit more. Before I do that, I want to add another element of art to my fish called texture. So remember, texture is how something feels. Okay, so now I need to add texture. So I want to pick a texture that looks like scales or at least looks pretty interesting. I have a couple different textures that you can use. There's a rolling texture where you can actually roll this onto your fish shape. There's some texture sheets that you could lay on top and press that texture on. I kind of like this one, and I also like this one. I'm going to try this one first, see how it turns out. So what you want to do is take the texture, put it on top of your clay, roll it with the rolling pin, and you're making an impression of that texture onto your fish. Now I'm going to peel it off. Wow, look at that awesome texture. That is so cool. So now I'm going to take the fish. It looks like there wasn't any texture on the tail. So I'm just going to use this texture for the tail. And I'm going to press down and roll it out. Ooh, I like that texture. I'm going to roll another one right here. And another one right here. Ooh, that looks really cool. And I'm pressing pretty hard with the texture. So now my fish is going to have some amazing texture on it. Now I'm going to take a toothpick and I'm going to use that to cut out the shape of my fish. And you use that to glue your pieces together. Ooh, it looks like mud. This slip needs a little bit of water. So you don't have to touch the slip with your hand. You can actually put it on a paintbrush. Take my eye. I'm going to put some of the slip on the eye. I'm going to put some slip right here where I want to glue it on. Then I'm going to scratch it a little bit with my toothpick. Scratching is called scoring. Now I can take the eye and I can press on it and make sure it won't fall off. Now I'm going to do the same thing with the pupil. I'm going to scratch it a little bit. There's my fish's eye. That looks so cool. Now I need to score and slip the fin. So I'm going to put slip, score it. Anything you glue onto your clay, when you join pieces of clay together, you have to score and slip. But don't press down too hard because all that texture will get wiped away. So now I am done cutting out the shape of the fish dish. Now I'm going to lift my fish up. I'm going to take my dish and I want to gently press down. I'm going to push it in a little bit. I don't want to press too hard because then will erase all that cool texture. But I want it to take the shape of a fish dish. And I'm going to smooth out the edges, smooth out the sides, and now for the most important part, writing your name. This is the most important part. So I'm going to write my name, J-A-M-I-E. If you have trouble writing on clay, you could always write it on the bowl or on a piece of paper, like a sticky note, and you could stick it right on top. Now I can leave my fish out to dry. If I don't finish it, then I want to wrap it up in a plastic bag so it stays wet. Ooh, I just added the eye. That looks good. But I'm finished with mine, so now I can leave it out to dry. And once the clay has gotten hard, then I will fire it. Or you can paint it with the glaze. But now it's finished, so I can let it dry out. And then I can think about what colors I want to paint my fish dish. All right, so once you're finished making your fish dish, put it on the drying shelf. Make sure it has your name and your teacher's code. If you don't put your name and your teacher's code, it will get lost. So I'm writing Jamie, if you're Miss Brown's house, BR2. I'm gonna stick it right on my fish, and then I'm gonna put it on the drying shelf. All right, so good luck. I can't wait to see how awesome your fish dish is. And remember, this is a three-dimensional sculpture. It has sides, a top, and a bottom. And we're making a dish that you can really use. Oh, don't forget, when it's cleanup time, after you put your fish on the shelf, make sure you don't get clay on the floor or in the sink. So we want to take all the extra clay and put it back in the bag so it doesn't dry out. We want to put our toothpicks back into the clay supply drawer and clean up all of your supplies and tables, because the classes that do a really good job cleaning up after clay get to do more than one clay project. But if you don't help clean up when it's cleanup time, you only get to do one clay project. So if you like using clay as much as I do, make sure you do a really good job helping clean up.